retail banking exec to replace Narev. The Commonwealth Bank of Australia, CBA, has announced a replacement for outgoing CEO Ian Narev, promoting Retail Banking Services Group Executive Matt Comyn to fill the top spot. According to the bank, the 42-year-old male boasts the best mix of attributes and values needed to lead CBA. Matt has gained respect across the banking sector both in Australia and globally. His track record is one of delivering very strong business performance, as well as a range of innovative, sustainable business improvements that have strengthened customer outcomes, CBA Chairwoman Catherine Livingstone said in a statement on Monday. Comyn has been with the bank since 1999, leaving briefly in 2010 to undertake a six-month stint as CEO at U.S. financial services company Morgan Stanley Smith Barney. He was promoted to the retail banking executive position in 2012. It is important that we maintain the momentum underway, upgrading and strengthening our governance, accountability, and risk management, while delivering strong financial performance, the incoming CEO said. We are in a period of significant technology and competitive change, and I look forward to ensuring we remain at the forefront of technology, innovation, and a great customer experience. As a retail banking boss, Comyn is credited as boosting the bank's active digital users to over 6 million, as well as bringing innovative digital tools to customers through CBA's financial well-being sector. Having previously been managing director of the bank's biggest digital business, CommSec, Comyn oversaw the digital modernization of its technology platform. Comyn also assisted Narev when CBA faced the House of Representatives Standing Committee on Economics review of the performance of Australia's banking and financial system last year. Comyn's base salary will be $2.2 million Australian dollars per year. Short-term variable remuneration will see an additional $2.2 million Australian dollars paid half in cash with the other half deferred for 2 years into equity. Additionally, long-term variable remuneration may be rewarded to Comyn to the tune of $3.96 million Australian dollars if approved by the board. Comyn will begin his new post on April 19, 2018, when Narev will depart after spending 6 years as CEO. Narev's departure was announced after civil penalty proceedings were initiated by the Australian Transaction Reports and Analysis Centre, AUSTRAC, against CBA in August. It was alleged by Australia's Financial Intelligence and Regulatory Agency that CBA had been involved in serious and systemic non-compliance with the Anti-Money Laundering and Counter-Terrorism Financing Act 2006. AUSTRAC detailed 53,700 alleged breaches of the Act, which included failing to hand 53,506 threshold transaction reports, TTRs, for cash transactions over 10,000 Australian dollars to AUSTRAC through intelligent deposit machines, IDMs, for almost 3 years between November 2012 and September 2015. The bank in December admitted that disparate datasets contributed to a contravention of the Act. CBA admits that at various times between about October 20, 2012 and October 12, 2015, due to an error in the process of merging data from two systems, its account-level automated transaction monitoring did not operate as intended in respect of 778,370 accounts, the bank wrote in its claim. CBA admits that this deficiency in its automated transaction monitoring over that period constituted a contravention of S82(1) of the Act. The bank said that in September 2015, its automated process was corrected so that TTRs were generated for transactions identified by the relevant transaction code. However, between November 2012 and September 2015, the automated process did not generate TTRs for 53,506 deposits of 10,000 Australian dollars or more through IDMs. In its defence, CBA has asked AUSTRAC to treat the contraventions as one course of conduct, arguing that the reports were late due to one system's related error. The bank faces a maximum penalty of 18 million Australian dollars for each of the contraventions if found guilty. For the 2017 financial year, CBA reported record after-tax profit of $9.88 billion Australian dollars, an increase of 4.6% over the previous year. Commonwealth Bank CEO Ian Narev to depart. The board of Australia's largest bank has said its CEO will retire, amid AUSTRAC alleging it has been involved in serious and systemic non-compliance with the Anti-Money Laundering and Counter-Terrorism Financing Act. CBA admits disparate data contributed to anti-money laundering contravention. The bank has admitted it was late in filing more than 53,500 reports as required under the Anti-Money Laundering and Counter-Terrorism Financing Act, but has asked for AUSTRAC to consider them as one course of conduct, arguing that it was due to one systems-related error. CommBank blames coding error for some alleged money laundering breaches. Australia's biggest bank is blaming an update for most of its failure to hand 53,506 threshold transaction reports to AUSTRAC. Commonwealth Bank's record $9.88 billion Australian dollars profit eclipsed by AUSTRAC proceedings. The bank reported $9.88 billion Australian dollars in profit for the 2017 financial year, but the heat is still on CEO Ian Narev amid allegations the bank has been involved in serious and systemic non-compliance with the country's anti-money laundering laws. Pega Systems helping CommBank, Sprint leverage AI for customer retention. Pega Systems CTO Don Schuerman believes organizations need to implement pragmatic artificial intelligence technologies just like the Commonwealth Bank and Sprint to avoid getting swept up in the AI hype.